So therefore,
you spit on me again.
I'm not spitting.
Yes, you are. You have.
I'm speaking.
Okay, so you need to calm down a little bit.
Question: is city ordinance violence a crime or not? Write down the answer in the comment. Welcome back to the channel. We have a video from Florida. This man did not commit any crime. The cops want to do his ID check. The reason? Well, he just parked his car and took some rest. Based on the police official's observation, the car is suspicious. He is violating city ordinance, which says you cannot use your vehicle as human occupancy. This innocent man did show the ID, but the cops were not satisfied with it. They wanted to check the car. Watch the video and share your opinion in the comments below. The original video is attached in the description.
Because you threatened me with arrest. You made a threat.
A threat because if you do not do something which you are legally required to do.
Unless I've broken a law.
I've committed a city ordinance violation.
A city ordinance isn't violating a crime. It's not a crime.
You're correct.
It is not a crime. Under the state of Florida, I am required to ID if I have committed a crime.
Or a city ordinance or county ordinance.
No, that's not the way the law reads.
Okay, I'm glad you know.
Now, because you're being polite, I will ID you.
I appreciate that.
You making threats?
Well,
that, you got the wrong guy for that, because we will take up the difference.
You gotta understand, he's not making threats. He's just telling you that if you do not do something.
No, that was a threat.
Exactly.
That was an outright threat.
It is a consequence of your actions if you don't identify yourself. I got it.
Okay.
And me and the mayor will be having a word before the day's out.
Absolutely.
Because there is nothing that says you cannot park down here and enjoy your time off the road. This is what this is for.
It's not for parking, okay?
It's not for parking.
It's for using your vehicle for human occupancy.
And the mayor is very supportive of us enforcing the city ordinance violations that he put into effect.
Whiskey.
Well, seeing how you just got done threatening me, now you violated my Fourth Amendment, so there are going to be repercussions for this.
That's the basis for the contact this morning.
Okay, I don't have a problem with the contact. What I had a problem with was a threat.
It wasn't a threat. It was
that was an outright
you failed
threat.
To identify yourself again. We're not going to sit here and play games all morning.
Who you failed to identify?
Your vehicle, and you'll be arrested for resisting.
Who failed to identify? You have my driver's license.
I do
who
now,
failed
correct.
To identify?
I do now, correct. So after I had to ask multiple times.
Well, the bottom line is, I have constitutional rights. That is a violation of my Fourth Amendment right. So, you want to play this game, we'll have attorneys in it, and I will have an attorney contacting, and I will file a civil lawsuit against Port Orange, and they got the right one. As a driver, I have the means as a commercial driver. I'm the one that runs FEMA in here at every storm. And if you don't remember from the last hurricane, when my truck was over there and the truck load of damn water I brought in, and the people I was carting out for them from over at the trailer park because nobody else could get through there except my damn truck. Yeah, it's convenient that you all don't remember. You're claiming, mind you, is not a crime. So therefore,
you spit on me again.
I'm not spitting.
Yes, you are. You
have. I'm speaking.
Okay, so you need to calm down a little bit.
You're within 6 foot of me. I'm sorry. This is the way I am.
You need to quit spitting when you talk to me.
I'm not spitting on you. I can make the same claim when you're talking to me.
Except for there's no spit flying out of my mouth.
There ain't no spit flying out of my mouth. So is there any other false accusations that you want to make? Is your video cam on?
Sure is.
Oh. Now you mind explaining that one to me?
What's that?
What that just was.
Yeah. I told you, you get to stand with me until he's done with his investigation. As soon as he's done, then he'll tell you what's going to happen today.
Well, I'm going to be going to the mayor's office as soon as I leave here.
Excellent.
Career Killer Audits. He is an amazing First Amendment auditor. In this video, he is exercising his First Amendment right, simply recording the public building. The employee called the cops on him. They wants to trespass him from this property. When asked what crime I committed, the police as well as the employee did not have any answer. As we all know, we have the right to film all government buildings and government officials. Later, three more cops get involved. But the auditor refuses to give any information and continued educating the cops and the employees on First Amendment rights. Watch the video and share your thoughts in the comments below. I have added the original link to Career Killer Audit's channel. Make sure you guys subscribe to his channel.
We're here to help somebody if they want to tell us, but he refuses to tell us anything.
Am I required to answer your questions?
There we go. That's
Am I required to answer his questions because he asked me something? I don't think so.
What's your name, sweetie?
I'm not going to tell you.
You got to tell me your name.
I do not.
Yes, when I get out with you, you have to tell me your name.
That's not true. Get your supervisor. What's your name and your badge number?
My name is Officer Bates. My badge number is 625. Would you like to speak with my supervisor?
Either your supervisor or your watch commander, one of the two. I know that's not your policy. And there's no refusing to give information as I'm not required because I haven't committed a crime.
Okay. Well,
just because you made contact with me.
Any business owner can put anybody.
This isn't a business. This is state probation. That means it is a public space.
You can still put people in first person.
Yeah, if they've committed a crime.
Like they don't want you here.
Okay. It's a public space. Can't be trespassed. I heard you the first time you said it. Yeah, I don't want to get charged for pedestrian in the roadway.
So I mean, we can help people, but if you don't tell us what you need, then
yeah.
It makes no sense. It's stupid.
Now it's stupid. Excellent.
I mean, we're there to help you, and if you tell us what it is,
Officer Bates, is this not a public space?
This is a
state probation office, correct?
Building.
It's a state probation office, which is upstairs, and it's a county building, correct? Which means it's a public space.
It's just like if you're standing in the courthouse and the bailiff says you need to leave the building, they can.
The bailiff is only confined to the courtroom. There's a state statute that.
No, they can make you leave the building. Yeah.
They cannot make you leave the building.
That's not right.
I never said I have a law degree, so don't make assumptions.
You're making assumptions.
I'm not. I'm educated on the purpose. I just left the courthouse. Doing the same exact thing.
Okay.
And you know why the officer didn't say anything? Because the First Amendment protected activity.
When I asked him, he said he was speaking to the supervisor and said, okay, what's your name? That's when he started. Yeah.
Because I'm not required to tell you my name. That's the gist of it. Just because you say so, I'm not required to. Yep.
Okay. I've never seen that.
I normally wear it on my shoulder.
I'm just asking out of pure interest.
Oh, you're fine. I've committed. Because he says that I don't have to commit
a
crime.
He came to the office and he told the lady up front.
No, he told you to ask for me to ask you.
She said that, he said, I want to speak to Sterling Hill supervisor, and they asked him, you know, what his name is. And this is how I got involved. I'm the assistant agent, aren't you?
Yes,
sir. And they said, he's videoing, he won't tell the name. So I come up there, and we're like, who are you here to see? I don't have to tell you that. Well, what's your name? I don't have to tell you that. I'm like, well, are you on probation? I don't have to tell you that. I'm like, well, if you're not on probation, and you won't tell us who you are, because the safety has, we have a lot of people support that, you need to leave the building. I don't have to leave the building. So you need to be leaving the building, we're going to place you on trespass. You won't tell us what you need, what you're about. Just, I want to talk to this person. We don't know if it's a setup on somebody, you know, he's going to assault a supervisor. We don't know. He won't tell us anything. So for safety, we're like, well, then you need to leave the building. It's some law enforcement, you know, up there. And he said, I'm not leaving the building. You need to step outside and place you on trespass.
Well, you're dealing with a whole lot of people here.
The principle is I'm not required to answer your questions in public. One, I'm not a probationer. I'm not on parole. I'm not required to answer your questions. Two, it's a public space. Three, you put your hands on me to remove me from a public space, which you didn't have. Did you not touch me? Did you touch me in the process? You're not answering the question. Did you touch me in the process?
Do what I was like.
Yeah, because I don't have to do what you say. That's what you don't understand. I don't have to do what you say. You have no governing authority over me.
But anyway,
I necessarily don't. Like I said, I came in here with the purpose to. That's what I said, and I respect your opinion. And there's some of us that do, but I didn't. I actually came in here with the purpose to see a supervisor, but someone asked me how can they help, and I said, no, you can't, because I didn't want to speak to that person. He wasn't the supervisor in charge. I knew he wasn't.
Next, we have a video from the channel Long Island Audit. This is the biggest channel on First Amendment rights. This video might be a little bit old, but I wanted to share it with you. In this video, Long Island Audit is filming the parking lot. Please note, this is not a private place. There are no signs which say that this is private property. One of the police officers gets super angry and tries to be physical with him, threatens to arrest him. According to the cop, this is private property, and you are not allowed to record here. This is against the law. You have to identify yourself. Long Island tries to educate this officer on the First Amendment right. He is not breaking any law, exercising his rights. But the cop refuses to accept the facts. The situation gets pretty heated. Long Island then requested the supervisor. Watch the video and share your opinion in the comments below. Please check Long Island Audit Channel. He is among the biggest First Amendment auditor. I have added his channel link in the description.
How are you doing today?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Are you videotaping?
I'm just videotaping.
Okay, I have a patient, so I would mind if you did not use that footage.
Okay. Don't touch me.
Okay, no problem.
Don't touch me.
I'm going to touch you if you don't cooperate.
Don't touch me.
You're on private property.
Don't touch me.
You're in the police station enclosed lot.
Don't touch me.
Let's go.
Don't touch me.
Okay, let's go.
Don't touch me.
I'm not touching you. I'm escorting you out of here.
Don't touch me.
Do you want to get placed under arrest?
For what?
That's the next option. Trespassing. For what?
You don't need to touch me.
Multiple signs dictating this
enclosed property. No, there is not. No, there is not.
And you just walk past me.
No, I didn't. Come in. Right over here.
Exactly.
So right over there.
So
no, they're not.
On. Let's go. I'm more than willing to walk with you.
Don't touch me.
I'm going to touch you. So
no, you're not.
Go.
No, I can walk.
Okay, so walk.
I can
more
walk.
More than willing to walk with you.
Don't touch me. I can walk.
Let's go, please.
I can walk.
Good.
What's wrong with you? G Martin, Sergeant?
Sergeant, 434.
434.
You are in enclosed parking.
No, I am not.
This is otherwise.
No, it's not.
Let's take a walk.
We're going to walk. Just don't touch me. What's wrong with you, man?
What's wrong with me? What's wrong with you? Why are you back?
You think you could just?
Lot?
Do you think that you could just touch people?
Absolutely.
Like you? No, you
Take
cannot.
Take your hands out of your pockets.
I'll put my hand right in my pocket.
Take your hands out of your pockets.
Don't say right. I'm gonna stay right here.
This
if there's no.
Open to public access.
This is all public.
Do you see the blue sign right
this
there?
This is all public.
I'm showing it to you right here. See the blue barricaded sign right there? That's where it's posted. So in all honesty, because of the work, we moved it because there's no access right now because of the safety issues with this work going on.
Okay.
So
what does that have to do with me?
This is where it was, meaning you're not allowed back here unless you're a law enforcement official use only. That's it. So let's proceed, please.
Please put your mask on. That's more of a safety hazard. Come on, man.
Please put your mask on.
I'm outside. You're the one coming up to me touching me. If
you're
worried
you're
about
private property.
If you were worried about coronavirus.
Private property.
If you no, it's not.
Yes, it is.
This is public property,
it's
sir.
Posted private property.
Let me ask you a question, Sergeant. Let me ask you a question.
As long as you get over here,
listen,
you can
stop. You gotta stop touching me. You gotta stop touching
that's
me.
That's not gonna happen if
you gotta stop touching
you're breaking
me.
The law.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I am not.
It's gonna be showing up.
No, I am not.
I'm telling you are.
No, I am not.
You can fight it in court.
I'm not.
You can fight it in court.
I'm not breaking the law.
I'm telling you right now you're breaking the law.
I'm telling you I'm not.
I'm telling you are.
This is a public.
Does not matter
this is
to me
a
right
public
now.
Building.
This is a public safety building. Hazard is what it's becoming.
Safety
we have ongoing
hazard.
Construction work.
This is
a, you walk right past.
This
it.
Is
Take
a,
your hands
this
out
is
your
a public building. This is a public building.
Correct.
Funded by taxpayers. Correct.
100% correct.
Okay. So that means this is public area and it's publicly accessible. If you want to put a
otherwise.
If, Sergeant, if you want to put a fence. Put a fence
why,
up.
Why would he put a fence? And we can't gain access.
Oh, you can open the fence.
That makes no sense. How about a sign?
A sign where? Where?
Right there. Let's
where? There is no sign. There is no sign.
Let's go look at it.
There is no sign.
You want to film it? Because you're not showing
There is no sign.
You can show anything you like.
There
I
is no sign.
Right here, okay?
There is no sign.
You're on video surveillance. I can care less if you're surveilling us. See? You're okay right here.
I'm okay wherever I want to be. I'm okay. Where? Go get it.
I'm not going
go
to
get
anything.
It.
Why would I get anything?
Go get it.
Absolutely not.
Go get it.
I'm telling you right now.
What's wrong with you guy?
Not
What's wrong with you?
Phone
What's wrong with you?
Do you need to make a report?
What's wrong with you?
There's absolutely nothing wrong with you.
I want to make a complaint against. I want to make a complaint against you.
No
now
problem.
I have
I'll
business
my,
here
I'll
now.
Be more happy to get my senior official to come out here and talk to
Great.
My supervisor.
Let's get him out here.
My complaint
because
right
you,
now is
I don't care about your complaint.
Somebody's breaking the law.
I don't care about I'm not breaking the law.
So I can either
You broke the law by touching me.
Absolutely not.
You broke the law.
I have somebody breaking the law trespassing.
You broke
to
the
you and remove you.
No,
100%.
You broke the law.
Would you like to talk to
you
one
broke
of my
the law. 100%.
Sit tight.
100%.
Tight.
100. What's your name and badge number, ma'am?
Officer Miller.
I understand.
Want to comply.
No.
You
I was trying to. You. No.
Situation.
No. Not true.
I
you grab. Who put their hands on who? You grabbed
I
me,
wanna
sir.
I want to get you to speak to my supervisor.
You grabbed me. I want to speak.
Correct?
Yes.
Please,
I want to.
By all means, what's your name?
I want to. I'm not giving you my name. You
what,
can put,
what am I going to say?
Okay, there you go.
Person?
You can put good
Samaritan, right?
No. Good citizen. Good citizen.
Citizen. What's your phone number, good citizen?
Good citizen.
What's your phone number?
I'll give it to the lieutenant.
What, are you going to wait here for him?
Yeah, I'm going to wait right here in public.
No problem. You're in allowed to wait right here. Like I told you back there, you're permitted right here. You're okay right here. This is open to the public right here.
I'm letting you, listen, Sergeant Martin, I'm telling you right now, you've been serving since 2007, correct?
Correct.
So what is that? 14 years?
Give or take.
Okay. So 14 years you've been a police officer.
Correct.
I'm telling you right now, you're not going to want to arrest me for not breaking the law. If there is no sign and if there is nothing saying... Hold on, let me finish, okay. And then you can talk. That's how this works.
Go ahead.
Okay, so if there is no sign saying that I can't be here, this is a public facility. I'm telling you, I've done this at Suffolk County Police Headquarters.
You can do it any
I've
way
done
you
it like. In places much
Perfect.
Bigger.
I want to make sure you see everything
much,
going on.
Great. Much bigger than this department
okay.
I've been at.
Yes.
And they have not arrested me. Do you know why, Sergeant?
I have no idea. I don't know part of those police departments.
Okay, but can I tell you why they didn't arrest me?
Please do.
Because I'm not breaking the law. And
okay,
you'd
fine.
Be making a very big mistake, Sergeant. I'm like,
first of all, I don't make big mistakes.
Okay.
Second of all,
touching me was
I
your first big mistake.
You weren't cooperating and you were breaking the law.
No, I was not. You're so, again, you're lying. I'm not breaking the law.
No.
I can walk wherever I want.
Not if I advise you otherwise. I'm
so,
the sole figure of this property, and I'm telling
unless
you,
I'm,
right
I,
now, this is
I,
private property past this point, which I explained to you over there.
I'm allowed
correct?
To speak.
Thank you, because I did the same to you.
Okay.
Right? Now, I told you this area, entrance to this area, is open to all public. Correct? Did I not tell you that?
Okay.
We can review the film if you'd like. Over there
You'll
is not. I advised you multiple times of that. You were not cooperating.
I was talking.
And then you're interfering with an aided investigation with somebody
I'm
needing
not
care.
I'm not interfering with any investigation against him.
A complaint in regards to what?
A complaint in regards. Do you guys have, first question for you, do you guys have a internal affairs division here?
Internal affairs? We do have a process that handles
that holds
civilian complaints
yes. against officers. Okay, great.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I want to do a formal one.
Okay.
I would also like to FOIA his record.
Okay, well, any FOIA requests are done right here on a form.
Okay.
We can do them online. It's also posted online on our website.
Okay.
So
I want to look up his disciplinary record.
Okay, well, here's the FOIA request.
Okay, great. So you want to hear about the complaint?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So I was outside filming. Conduct
and stuff in the back, and that's why no one's allowed back there. And for the safety of our department vehicles and equipment we have back there.
Okay.
So you do understand that now.
And that's fine. I mean, you guys should just have signs, maybe even a gate.
Like I said, we did have signs, but obviously under the condition of a parking lot and the construction.
Okay.
And I
would agree with you that I could understand that. I could understand you are going through construction. What I won't understand is Sergeant Martin's excessive force used on a non-law break. I was, like I said, if there's no signs, that means I'm there legally with a First Amendment protected activity, conducting one. You guys swore oaths to the Constitution.
I understand that.
Okay.
I'll look into it, but I'll have to take your information, obviously.
Okay.
If you want to make a
complaint. Great. You could put my name. You'll figure out my name eventually.
I can't use.
Yes, you
citizen.
Can. I've done this plenty of times. You're gonna see.
If you want to make a complaint, I need your.
I'll give you my phone number, and so you can reach out to me, and you can put good citizen.
So your name is good. First name is good.
Yeah. It does.
Okay.
So I appreciate you looking into this for me and doing your job and upholding your oath to the Constitution.
All right. Have a good day.
Thanks. You too.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more First Amendment videos.